Good morning on Friday the 12th of February. The Reverend Barbara hopes everyone is well and sends her love and blessings. Today's opening prayer. God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, whose mercies are new every day, let the radiance of the Holy Spirit renew our lives, warm our hearts, give light to our minds, and help us to apply wisdom at all times. Amen. Today's readings are from Mark's Gospel, chapter 7, verses 31 to 37, and Psalm 32, verses 1 to 8. When I was speaking last Sunday, I commented that a popular quiz question is, what are the first five words of the Bible? And I've noticed that over recent months, an increasing popular quiz category is that linked to naming Nobel Prize winners. I don't know about you, but I'm far better at naming the winners of the Peace Prize compared with, say, the winners of the medical category. Yet, if we look at the names of the winners of the Nobel Prize for Medicine and what they have achieved, we are reminded about the wonderful developments which have taken place in the field of medicine over the years. And these developments are ongoing. We regularly hear about medical research in all sorts of areas. And of course, recently, the COVID-19 vaccine is an obvious example. And don't they all make it sound so easy? We're told the virus has mutated, and then in the next interview, we find one of the researchers, oh, we'll just tweak the vaccine to cover that. In the same way that they would just tighten a washing line. But of course it isn't as easy as it sounds. And some of the major developments which have taken place and which have had the widest impact for humans other than vaccinations relate to the improvement of our senses when they are damaged. When I recently touched on our sense of smell, I commented how we don't realize how much we use our senses because they are just part of us. Last spring, many people said how much they enjoyed hearing birdsong. And we heard it that much better because there was less general noise around. And I know that many of you were amused when the birds seemed to be competing with me as I talked. And it was with that in mind that I smiled a few days ago when I heard sustained birdsong for the first time in 2021. Having said that, I think that the present cold means that any self-respecting bird will have hibernated again. But even if the bird song is occasionally modestly frustrating, it is also a wonder and a delight to be able to hear it. And with the use of implants and other advanced technology, many more people are able to hear things which in the past they wouldn't have been able to. In Jesus' time, life was very difficult for people who had impaired hearing, especially if their speech was also affected. When Jesus restores the man's hearing and speech, he gives him a really precious gift. a true lifeline, because it would completely transform his life and his ability to do everyday activity. These are things which we should never take for granted. And you may even want to add thanks for our sense of hearing to your thanks chain today. But I also think it's worth stopping to think how we use both our hearing and our speech. What do we choose to listen to? And what do we choose to say? And we should remember the importance of giving time to listen to God and to speak about Him. I now come to a general prayer about healing. Loving Lord, we pray for all who are suffering because of the cruelty of others. We think of those who have no confidence in themselves or in the world. We pray for everyone who struggles with relationships and remember the lonely. Please be close to all who are rejected or feel betrayed. And we pray for everyone who is in trouble, need, or sickness. We name them in the quiet of our hearts, and we particularly think of anyone who does have a problem with any of their five main senses. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We now come to our prayer points today. To pray for all who are involved in medical research. To pray for the nurses and doctors, that they are able to get sufficient rest so that they can complete their duties in a satisfactory manner. And let's pray for all people who are suffering from the after effects of COVID-19. And I'll come to the Lord's Prayer. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Bit by bit, I'm managing to get the Lent booklets out to people. So if you haven't received yours yet, don't worry. Hopefully, it will be delivered by next Wednesday. And our blessing for today, the God of hope, give you courage in times of trouble and strength in times of weakness. And the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be with you today and evermore. Amen.